So, I don't need to explain to you who Sneako is, since if you've had some search of the internet for the past couple of months, you've most likely heard of him. And you most likely heard of who Sneako was because of the controversy he has dug himself into recently. For the past couple of months, Sneako and the YouTuber Critical have been going at each other for a while, where it all started off because Critical slightly criticized Sneako, which resulted in Sneako doing some pretty petty stuff to Critical for no reason. If you've been subbed to the channel for a while or just a couple months, you will know that I've always had a weird view on Sneako for his over-the-top persona that he has presented to the public, and this entire situation has painted a perfect representation of how Sneako acts, and this entire controversy has left the entire community clown on him, and even some of his old-time fans. This is a situation that I've been following for a while and I've been pretty interested in. So, in this video, we're gonna be covering the entire situation, from when it all started from Sneako making fun of Charlie's girlfriend for no reason, to the two talking to each other and pretty much squashing their beef with each other. So without further ado, subscribe, drop a like, and let's get into the video. So, if we all know Sneako, we all know how defensive he gets to get super aggressive over something small. And that's exactly what happened here. On May 12th, 2022, Critical will go on to post a video criticizing Fresh and Fit, which, if you don't already know, Fresh and Fit is basically a worse version of Sneako. Then later on in November of that year, Sneako will come across Critical's video clown on Fresh and Fit, and Sneako being the man he is will defend Fresh and Fit to the fullest, and Sneako wouldn't just stop there. Throughout his livestream, he would go on to get more and more upset, and he would go on to make fun of a picture of Critical's girlfriend, and would try to swoop put into this rising controversy.
You know what's funny? Someone just texted me. I'm not gonna say names. Someone texted me. He's in a monogamous relationship. This is his girl. So there you go. I mean, I told you, like, I could hear it in your voice. The fact that someone doesn't have to abide by those rules, someone could go and fuck a lot of bitches.
Which is something very petty to do. But when Sneako made fun of Critical's girlfriend, Charlie didn't respond to this right away. But this topic of Sneako making fun of Critical's girlfriend would begin to start to circle around the internet, and eventually it would begin to make its way to different Reddit communities, resulting in Charlie making a response video to Sneako on November 25th, 2022. Where in his response video, Critical completely, I would say, owned Sneako in this video. And she went over how Sneako got offended because he made a little joke about Fresh and Fit, and in this video, Critical didn't try to hide his frustration.
I started throwing some balls at the clown and dunking them in the tank. I made a video talking and joking about it, and Sneako saw this and he wasn't too happy, so he got offended on his friend's behalf, which of course is a very alpha male thing to do.
So there you go. I mean, I told you, like, I could hear it in your voice. The fact that someone doesn't have to abide by those rules, someone could go and fuck a lot of bitches, that it's so foreign to a lot of people's ideas, because when you get brainwashed, when you get told that monogamy is the answer.
What the fuck are you even talking about? What does this have to do with anything? What does bringing up a picture of me and my girlfriend have anything to do with anything that has happened? And where is monogamy even coming from? You're fighting an invisible enemy right now. You're fighting ghosts that aren't real.
Once Charlie dropped this video, people would all begin to support him, since Critical, being one of the nicest and most respected creators on the platform, honestly didn't deserve to be ridiculed and be made fun of by Sneako. And later in that same video, Critical would go on to mention how Sneako likes supporting a movie that heavily sexualizes kids.
I first became aware of his content when he got mad at me a couple years ago because I was criticizing a movie called Cuties. For those that don't know, Cuties was a movie that went to Netflix, and it was basically just softcore child. It was a movie that focused on twerking and a coming-of-age film that used real children in real positions of, like, sexualization, where during, like, a twerking contest, they'd have cameras that would go, like, right into their ass and zoom in. It was disgusting stuff.
And if Charlie's video didn't already own Sneako, towards the end of the video, Critical will go to mention how Sneako let his girlfriend get, well, I'm just gonna let this play.
But I couldn't help but take notice of one of his more recent viral clips where he openly defends getting cucked.
So I wanted to break this down, like, because this was, imagine seeing the girl you love, like,
get fucked.
You love her? Yeah, I do. I love her. Yeah, I love her. I was about to say I love this bitch. I'm like, no, let me not say that. I love my
queen.
Wifey, my queen.
And you allow the love of your life to get fucked by another man.
What happened to the other three?
I'm crazy. The first time, as soon as I saw like three pumps in, I just got up and walked out.
Later on, after Charlie made this video humiliating Sneako, on Twitter, Sneako was going to make a tweet with pictures of creators that he didn't like. And in the middle of the picture is Critical. And Sneako was going to make more tweets making fun of Critical, even though the people have all said that Critical completely won this little feud. But the two were going to have a little argument on Twitter, where it all started by this tweet made by Sneako. Holy shit, you pathetic, sensitive, soy little worm. I made fun of you watching a girlfriend get fucked by numerous other men and also insulted for you defending child. That's not a cancellation. That's just spitting on you for being a pitiful, sad cuck. You know in your soul that you would never say that to my face. You literally have a cloud of people that hurt your feelings on the internet. You haven't stopped whining about me for months now, you goofy NPC. Even if you beat my ass in a fight, it doesn't change the truth. You're still a cuck who defends child. You're not special from the other 10 soy boys who say the same thing. You got a problem? Stop talking on the internet. Let's solve it. Having some people wondering if Sneako meant that he was gonna box Critical. But Critical will gonna make his last response tweet about this Twitter argument. Got your Discord still working on responses? Brother, I have no problem. You started and I made fun of your return. You're upset about public main to Cuckerly and getting mad about me for bringing it up. You should be mad at yourself instead. Have some self-reflection. And most people again all sided with Critical. Since most people could tell that Sneako was being childish, it could clearly tell that Sneako was butthurt because Critical made fun of him in his video. But this entire situation would get even more amped up later on. Around this time when everyone thought that the drama would be settled, it would be apparent that Sneako would begin to start threatening Charlie. On March 12th, 2023, Sneako would tweet, "Soy boy keyboard warrior, where's Critical?" We all know that he wouldn't accept the fight. Lil bro is 5'3", pasty gaming manlet.
No one says that.
Has some empathy. What matters is how most influential commentators have no specific beliefs. They never get canceled, they just talk. Why do you listen? And just a few hours after this tweet was posted, Critical would post another video about Sneako, where in the video, his frustration would be apparent, as he goes on to say how Sneako has been non-stop talking about him for 3 months straight.
"I'm not kidding, I really didn't want to keep talking about you, but you won't stop talking and crying about me. It's sad. I understand you have a humiliation fetish, so hopefully this whole thing has helped you orgasm one more time from all of it."
And also in the video, Critical shows a clip of Sneako dancing with a gun and waving it around, trying to act intimidating.
"Day after I posted my response, he went on stream and had a huge unhinged tantrum and meltdown about the whole thing, and then he sent some of his viewers over. So I was joking with them, saying like, 'Oh, you guys must have just stopped the cuties watch party over there at Sneako's stream, right? Welcome cucks,' that kind of shit. And it got really under his skin in a big way, so he started dancing around with the gun and threatening to come shoot me."
But even though Sneako was trying to look tough with the gun and intimidate people with it, he would somehow get embarrassed, because Charlie would go on to rip into Sneako and give him a little gun mentor.
"And I'm sorry to be that guy, this is like the grammar police of guns, but he's a f***ing imbecile, you absolute buffoon. What you have there is not clips. These are mags. They're mags, not clips, you absolute fucking dummy. The same way that this is also a mag. They're all mags. Stop saying clips, you look fucking stupid here."
And if Critical didn't already embarrass Sneako even more, well, he goes on to expose that the fact that Sneako relies on his Discord server for insults to fire back at people with.
"I also love that you treat this Discord server like it's your PR team, so you have them work on your responses on Twitter because you're not witty enough to come up with anything on your own. You have no ability to banter. You can't insult anyone. Anytime you're pushed, all you fall back on is one of three things: soy boy, bot, or NPC, and that's it. You never deviate from this path."
Later in Charlie's response video, he also mentions how Turkey Tom made a video on Sneako, and when Sneako saw Turkey Tom's video, he had challenged Tom to a debate, in which Tom agreed to. But when Tom agreed to debate Sneako, then Sneako just went silent.
What's even sadder about it is he purposely leaves out people that he's afraid of. So Turkey Tom, for example, made a whole video talking about Sneako and how pathetic he is, and Sneako tried to talk a big game to him, even challenged him to a debate, which Turkey Tom accepted with jubilation. He was ecstatic. And then Sneako kept ducking him, ghosting him. So he leaves Turkey Tom off of this list because he's afraid to actually talk to him.
Critical's response to Sneako would gain over 12 million views and would gain over 1 million likes, with all the comments roasting Sneako. This part definitely shows Sneako's childish behavior, as he literally tried to threaten someone and challenge someone to a fight for no reason. And not to mention, all of this started because Critical roasted someone else who wasn't even Sneako. But Sneako wouldn't stop there, as he now figured out that people were all against him, so he would go on to double down basically. On March 16th, 2023, YouTuber and streamer Aiden Ross would go on to react to Critical's response to Sneako, where throughout his live stream, Aiden Ross would go on to call up Sneako and ask him for a statement about the situation. And in typical Sneako fashion, he would go on to see how Critical wouldn't say the stuff to his face, essentially.
"So let me ask you, if you saw him walking down the street, what are you doing?"
"I would walk up to him and I would say the same stuff that you said in your videos. I would look him dead in the eye and say, 'All that stuff you said in your videos, say it to my face right now,' and I know that he would freeze up and not say a word. This is why I'm sick of the internet and why we should spend more time in the real world, because this is garbage, bro. Does anyone in the chat think that he would say any of this face-to-face?
Which is just the generic response to say. But a couple days later, on March 18, 2023, Aiden Ross was going to bring along Sneako to his live stream, where in his live stream, he would have Sneako explain more about the drama and give more insight about the entire situation, where the first thing that Sneako would say is how the gun lesson that Critical did in his video was a white person thing to do. And Aiden Ross says that Moist Critical had owned him, essentially, and Sneako would try to defend himself.
I just want to ask you, first of all, the Moist Critical situation. You know, you start, it was so funny. You're like dancing with a fucking gun, like right here, like just dancing. And he says about like some clips. Like, I'm gonna be honest, bro. He did really own you. You know, he did. Come on.
Own me, bro. That's it. Okay, you just talk. Hold on. You talk about white people. That's some white people shit to be like, oh, clips, magazines. Bro, everybody says clip. Is that really an own to be like, actually, yes. It's called magazine. Come on, bro.
Before Aiden Ross's stream went live, Sneako would want to say that he would be debating Charlie in the stream. But when it came to the live stream, Charlie didn't want to debate Sneako. To which Sneako would try to use that as a response that Charlie was just being soft and scared. Which, because Critical probably didn't want to be involved in some child debate. But in Aiden Ross's stream, he finally asked the golden question. What were they beefing over?
Alright, listen, bro. So why were you and him even beefing in the first place? What happened? Please, tell me.
Okay, you want to know why? I'll explain it, and I would prefer to just go talk to him, because this back and forth, this drama stuff, you know, all the Twitter pages are going to clip this up, and all the, you know what I'm saying, the Dixerto, Jake Sucky, these people are going to clip it up. But the reason we started beefing was because I first heard about Fresh and Fit from a hit piece of his video, from one of his videos.
Chat, he lies. Troll or no?
All he does is lie. He lied when Tate got locked up. He said that Greta Thunberg doxed him for the pizza box. That's not true. How stupid do you have to be? The guy's 30 plus, and he really believes that they don't check your passport when you enter an airport. He doesn't think that two of the most high profile people in the world, Andrew and Tristan Tate, would have been tracked entering Romania. He legitimately got on camera and said, Greta Thunberg doxed him because the pizza box. All these Soy Boy channels, the same ones that are making hit pieces on me and you right now, they all lied and believed in the stupid
real quick, real quick.
But nonetheless, throughout Aiden Ross' stream, Sneako just kept recycling through the same points. He looks like a chomo and he's a Soy Boy. And without a doubt, the entire commentary community would make a bunch of videos covering Sneako's hypocrisy. As now by this time, it pretty much just became a meme to make fun of Sneako. Throughout this video, we've covered Sneako being extremely childish. However, things will begin to change. On March 26, 2023, the animation channel MeCanon were going to post a video called Sneako Meets Charlie, where in the video, it displays Sneako live streaming, and in the background, it shows someone in his bed with his girlfriend. And then later on, it shows Critical going into Sneako's house and destroying him, basically. Now, what's funny here is that Sneako going to say this on Twitter, yo, MeCanon, I can't even lie, that was a funny ass video. Which was a more different response from Sneako, since essentially any video making fun of Sneako, he would take that and throw a fit about it, but this time he didn't. So then the next day, Sneako was going to post a video on Rumble called I Love the New Sneako, which was mainly his official response to Critical. And in the video, he goes on to take a few shots at Critical, saying how YouTube promotes bad stuff like what Critical does, and also mentions how the name Critical doesn't stand for anything. However, after taking multiple shots at Critical in this video, he would go on to end off the video on a more positive note.
I'm officially retiring the Soy Boy image. I forgive everybody who advocated for my cancellation or made documentaries about me, and I'm ditching my attacking style of streaming. And I apologize to Moist Critical for showing a picture on stream of you and your girlfriend. That was not very Christ-like. I'm sorry.
This video was much different than any of other Sneako's videos, as him apologizing to Critical was what most people were looking for. However, after apologizing to Critical, 24 hours later, Sneako was going to go on another rant. Kai Sent, Your Rage, Gideon, Aiden Ross, Hassan, XQC, Asmongold, literally every streamer and YouTuber reacted to Moist Critical's video about me. Not one reacts on my response video, even the people I've defended. I defended Kai Sent from grape allegations, defended Your Rage from when Twitch banned him, defended Gideon from Pokemon hate, defended Aiden Ross from getting Twitter cancelled. Not one of them has my back when I'm against the wall. Not one. The Soy Boys understandably have an agenda. I made the mistake of thinking that there were friends in this game. They will use you for clout. Not one of them care about the truth. They want to turn me into a meme. It's not about anything but views. Pay close attention. But when Sneako made this rant, Kai Sent himself would actually go on to respond to this.
Bro, first of all, I didn't even know drop the did anybody else know that he dropped like a comeback video, some a response video?
You.
Bro, I don't be on Rumble, my nigga. Bro, I don't even be on Rumble, bro. I don't even be on Rumble, bro. So that's tough. You know, now you just gotta move accordingly now. Now, well, that is what it is. You just know.
It's,
On April 1st, 2023, Moist Critical went to post a video called I Talked to Sneako, which at the time I actually thought it was just a joke because it was April Fool's Day, but it wasn't. This was a huge video, since for the past 4 months, the two just been having constant beef with each other, and most people in the community could have never seen Critical and Sneako actually talking to each other. However, in the video, Critical does mention that there were some things that they still disagreements on, like the topic of the movie Cuties. They would go back and forth, Sneako saying why Cuties is a good movie, and Charlie saying why it isn't. And another thing that Sneako told Charlie was that the fact that Charlie never leaves his room, apparently.
And I don't know how many years I've seen you on YouTube. I've never seen you out of your room. I've seen you with dildos in your room throwing it at each other and your friends. I've never seen you travel. I've never seen you network with other people. I've never seen you show your audience what's possible if they make money as well. I've seen you play video games since like 2016.
Now, the funny part here is that Charlie would go on to mention how after he'd finished debating Sneako, he said they had a much different view on him now. As when the two were talking to each other, it was a much different view of Sneako, as he didn't present his childish behavior.
And this was a very different side of Sneako. I went into this expecting him to be his standard, unhinged, like very animated cartoonish self that I see in all of his content on Twitter and Rumble, where he's doing these like temper tantrums and like throwing his ass in a circle and going wild, hog wild. This was a very laid back, very calm and collected Sneako, who was actually more than willing to concede on some of his points as well as see different sides of situations.
But all in all, through this conversation, they would discuss about everything that they previously disagreed on. And even Critic would even say that this is the best drama conversation of all time in his description. And it would have majority of the people in the comments section saying how Sneako and Charlie had a really good conversation. And from there, the beef has pretty much been settled. So, I think I can firmly say that my little Sneako saga is over now. For the longest time, Sneako has always had this over-the-top, thinking he's always right persona, and having a trend of supporting bullying, but then when he gets bullied, then all of a sudden it's a problem now. But now he's finally came to the realization that he's not always right. This entire situation just started from hurt feelings and pettiness from Sneako, as like I said in my other videos, Sneako became the thing that he hated. And now, even Sneako has admitted to himself that Critical's view and Critical himself has sort of changed him now, and he's also finally admitted now that he shouldn't be that type of over-the-top aggressive person now, since screaming at your camera and being aggressive for no reason does not do any good for anyone. But as of now, the entire controversy is pretty much settled from here, and let's just hope that it stays that way. But knowing Sneako, we just never know if he might come back with another video criticizing Critical, or just taking random shots at him again. But that's all for today's video. If you guys did enjoy this video, then consider subscribing and drop a like if you want to. Go follow my Twitter at Scorpion_1, and consider joining the Discord. But thank you for the support recently, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out.